Hello, dear friends. I hope everybody's doing well. Today, we're going to talk about butterfly pose, which is a yin pose. This is Tara. She'll be helping us.
Hello.
So Tara, bring the soles of the feet together. And keep your feet a little bit further out, away from your groin. So you have this diamond shape inside your legs. And lengthen your spine slightly as you take a deep inhalation, creating a little space. And then as we exhale, we're going to simply bend forward and lower the head down, however much your body will allow you to do that. But it's not going to be this easy for many people, so I'm going to show you modifications. First modification we'll do is raise our hips higher than the knees. So we can sit either on a bolster or a block. So in this case, she'll be sitting on a bolster. You can also sit on a blanket, but this bolster might be a little too high. Great, and same way, bring the feet together, keep them further out, and then exhaling, simply fold forward. Beautiful. As you can see, the hips are higher than the knees, and the pelvis is allowed to tilt forward a little bit more, so your spine can come down. And again, you just hold this for a time. This is one way to modify this pose. Thank you very much, come up. Now, the second thing you can do is, let's say if you have neck injuries, you can, if you have any neck pain, because we'll be holding this for time, maybe 5 minutes, it'll be a good idea to rest your head on a block. So just simply lower down, place your forehead on the block. As simple as that. And even if you don't have neck injuries, it might be a good idea to do that. It's not a bad modification. Good. The next thing we can do, if you have knee pain, and a lot of times knee pain happens because of the tightness of the hips. So take two blocks and place them under your knees. And again, simply fold forward. Beautiful. And lastly, same thing here. You can place the bolster under your belly. And just comfortably place your head down. You will still get the full benefit of this posture. One of the benefits of this pose is to stretch the lower back. It doesn't require that you have loose hamstrings. So it's approachable whether you have loose or tight hamstrings. This pose is good for the kidneys and the prostate, and it is highly recommended for people who have been suffering with urinary problems. It helps women with their periods, regulating their cycle and their ovaries, and it makes childbirth easier. What are some of the indications that you should avoid this posture or maybe modify it? So if you have sciatica, you definitely sit on a higher surface so that your hips are higher than your knees. Okay? And or completely avoid this pose. It depends how extreme your sciatica pain is. If you have lower back disorder or low back pain, do not allow your back to round. Just sit up straight and keep your back as straight as possible, and then just simply fold forward as much as your body will allow without rounding your back. Just keep your spine straight at all times. And of course, if you have neck pain or neck injuries, definitely sit up straight, or depending on the extremity of the pain or the injury, rest your forehead on a bolster or a block. The meridians that are working in this pose are the meridians running on the outer side of your legs, on the outer thighs, and those are the meridians for the gallbladder and the urinary bladder. And the meridians, as you fold forward, they go on both sides of your lower back, lower spine. So you also get the kidneys and the liver meridian stimulated if your feet are closer to your groins. The meridians that run on the inner thighs are the kidney and the liver meridians. And finally, the intention of this practice is up to you. Your intention can be the physiological, you know, benefits of the pose, stretching your body, your tissues, your muscles, everything else that you're stretching, or the benefits or the intention of your practice can be more emotional and psychological. So that will inspire you to work on the quality of your mindfulness. I hope this was helpful. This is one of the poses we'll do this Sunday, and I will be live streaming at 12 o'clock, and this will be a 3-hour workshop. And we'll do the poses like this, and we'll talk about the postures just like I did today, the benefits, how to modify them, and I'll give you different cues on how to be more mindful, you know. And those of you who have taken my workshops before, you know, sometimes I'll throw in a story or two, and that sort of go parallel with the postures and, you know, the mindfulness of the practice. If you'd like to sign up for the workshop, please go to the link on my bio. And when you sign up for the workshop, you will get a link, and you can follow the link to our online streaming class. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you, Tara. I'll see you guys Sunday.